Namaste Chairmans, I am Chairman Shobha Kumari, Assistant Professor in Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Today we are continuing with the session of rice and package practices, crop production practices. In India, rice is mainly grown in two types of soil, upland and lowland. The method of the cultivation of rice is in a particular region depend largely on the factors such as the situation of land, type of soil, irrigation facility, and availability of labors, and the intensity and distribution of rainfall. The crop of rice is grown with the following method: dry, semi-dry upland cultivation. Broadcasting the in the method dry or semi-dry upland cultivation. In this method, two methods are involved for the sowing: broadcasting the seeds, sowing the seed behind the plow, drilling, and second method, wet or lowland cultivation. In this method, transplanting in puddle field, broadcasting sprouted seed in puddle fields. Select how to select the seeds for the cultivation. The use of quality seed in cultivation rice is an important factor to get better crop yield. Therefore, proper care has to be taken in selecting seeds of the best quality. Much of the success in raising the healthy seedling depends on the quality of seeds. Seed intended for the sowing should be satisfy the following requirement. The seed should be belong to the proper variety which is proposed to be grown. The seed should be clean and free from the obvious mixture of the other seed. The seed should be mature, well developed, and plump in size. The seed should be free from obvious sign of age and bad storage. The seed should be high germinating capacity. Before sowing, the seed should be treated with the fungicide which protect the seed against soil borne fungi and also give a boost to the seedling. Method for the nursery raising, there are the three major method of raising nursery. First one, the dry nursery, where the dry seed is sown in the dry soil. This method is practiced in the area where water is not sufficient to grow seedling in a wet nursery. Second one, wet nursery, where the sprouted seed is sown the most puddle soil. Wet nursery are preferred under irrigated condition. Last one, and the Depok method. This method of raising nursery has been introduced in India from the Philippines. Depok method is commonly prevalent in the Philippines. The essential feature of this method is to have very thick and stand of the nursery seedling without any contact with the soil. Generally, seedling become ready for transplanting in 12 to 14 days. Seed rate for rice cultivation per hectare. The seed rate naturally influence the growth of seedling. This sowing gives strong and a tillered seedling, whereas thick sowing provides thin and tall seedling without tiller. Thin sowing in nursery is always better, and it will produce strong and sturdy seedling, which can withstand adverse climatic condition better and produce better yield. Therefore, 40 to 60 grams of seed per square meter should be sown in a nursery bed. About 500 square meter area nursery is sufficient to transplant 1 hectare area. In case of late sowing nursery, the nursery area should be increased 750 to 1000 square meter. Before transplanting, field should be puddled properly with bullock and tractor drawn puddler. Puddling is a very important operation in the transplanted rice. Puddling helps to kill the weed and buries them in a puddled soil. It is also suppress the germination of weeds in subsequent growing of the period of crop. Puddling keep the soil surface is a more even condition, beside creating beneficial physical, biological, and chemical condition for rice plant growth. The transplanting should be done with the proper age of seedling. In case of short duration variety, the seedling should be uprooted from the nursery bed for transplanting when it's 3 to 4 weeks old. In case of medium and long duration variety, 4 to 5 weeks old seedling should be transplanted. Always healthy seedling should be used for transplanting at the 4 to 5 leaf stage when they are about 15 to 20 centimeter high. As far as possible, delayed transplantation should be avoided, because it lead to poor tillering, early flowering of the main tillers, and resulting in the reduction in yield. In alkaline soil, aged old seedling of 45 days old should be transplanted, because old seedling establish better than the young seedling of 25 days age in alkaline condition. Spacing under good management and adequate nitrogen level, the optimum spacing for the varieties like IR Art should be around 20 into 10 cm, 20 row-to-row distance and 10 cm plant distance, both for the Kharif and Rabi crops. With excellent culture practices, the spacing may be slightly wider, 20 into 15 cm, but under some normal conditions, the spacing should be slightly narrower, 15 into 10 cm. Number of seedling per hill. Hill transplanting 2 to 3 seedling per hill under normal condition. The use of more seedling per hill, besides not being any additional advantage, involve an extra expense on the seedling. In case of transplanting with old seedling, the number of seedling per hill can be increased. Depth of planting direction of row. Depth of planting has assumed considerable importance after the introduction of high yielding varieties. The high yielding varieties are characterized with the high tilling capacity. The high tilling potential of these varieties is, however, best expressed with the shallow planting. The tiller bud form at the basal node are the not suppressed in the case of shallow planting. Therefore, the seedling should be transplanted at 2 to 3 cm depth. Practicing direct seeded crops. Where we choose direct seeded method for the cultivation of rice, the success of the direct seeded rice depend entirely on the monsoon. Besides a proper stand of crop, if sowing is done in a properly prepared land, proper stand of crop can be achieved. And a field with the fine till facility, the seed to become in a contact with the soil moisture after drilling and enables the seed to germinate quickly and uniform. Thus, ideal preparation of the land will help to achieve a uniform extent, facilitate wedding and fertilizer practices. Therefore, number of plowing of the field and timely sowing, the direct seeded crop generally gives better yield. Different methods of seeding is done with the three different ways: drilling, dibbling, and broadcasting. Manure and fertilizer application. Organic manure are as important for the rice cultivation as in the organic fertilizer. In case of upland rice cultivation, the use of bulky organic manure is very much desirable in order to maintain the physical condition of the soil and also to increase the water holding capacity of the soil for maximum utilization of the rainwater. In upland field, 10 to 50 tons per ton of well-loaded FIM farmyard manure or compost should be applied in 1 hectare area, preferably 4 to 6 weeks before sowing. Organic manure should be spread evenly on the upper surface of the soil and plowed into get it well mixed in the soil. Water management. Water requirement of the rice crop is comparatively higher than any other crops of similar duration assured, and timely supply of irrigation water has considerable influence on the yield of crops. During the crop growth period, the water requirement is generally high at the initial stage, initial seedling establishment stage. After the transplanting, water should be allowed to stand in the field at the depth of 2 to 5 cm till the seedlings are well established. The second, the most important critical stage is drilling to flowering, and in this period, the crop should not be subjected to soil moisture stress. The water supply should be ensured in required amount during the panicle initiation to flowering stage. The about 5 cm depth of water should be maintained in the field up to tough stage of the crop. Before harvesting, water should be drained out from the field to allow quick and uniform maturity of grain. Harvesting and threshing of rice. The maximum quantity and better quality paddy and rice depend on the harvesting of the crop at the correct maturity stage. Therefore, it is of the paramount importance to harvest the crop at suitable time. Harvesting of the crop when it is not fully matured might result in loss of yield with poor quality grains. If harvested is delayed, grain may be lost due to the damage by the rat, bird, insect, shattering, and losing. Thus, timely harvest ensure a better and good quality of grains, consumer acceptance, and less breakage, and when mild, The right stage for harvesting is commonly understood by the layman is when the panicle turn into golden yellow and the grain contain about 20% moisture. When the moisture in the paddy grain reaches 16 to 17% in the standing crop in the field, the crop sustained a heavy loss owing to shedding and damage by the birds and rodents. Thank you guys. If you have any doubt, any query regarding this session, please write in comment box.